Well, most of the people that come to the National Archives, believe it or not, at least 70% come to do family research. You can see their eyes wetting up and tears coming to find one of their ancestors, because basically they're looking for who they are and where they come from.
It gives you a certain sense of identity. You know who you are, you know who your ancestors were, you know, in my own case, the contributions my ancestors made to the history of this country. I have 13 ancestors who fought in the Revolution. I have several ancestors who fought in the Civil War. I have relatives who fought in the Second World War. I have an ancestor who read the Declaration of Independence on July 8, 1776 in Easton, Pennsylvania. It was one of three places where that document was read that day. So that gives me an incredible sense of my family's history in the context of American history. The National Archives is an incredible facility for historians, both family historians and general historians, because you actually get to work with the original documents. And we're not talking abstracts of documents, we're not talking published sources, we're talking with the original records.
This is a typical stack area where we have our Civil War pension files. And as you can see, these are an enormous amount of files. This stack area is not open to the general public, but this is where the technicians would come to pull the documents to bring to the research room where researchers can examine these files. And the pension file, as anyone would know, normally holds a great deal of information about genealogy. You can find marriage records, you can find affidavits of people who knew the individuals who served, you can find records relating to comrades that served with an individual. This happens to be a particular pension file, and this is what the folder looks like, and it contains all of this genealogical and historically related information. You get a great joy of helping individuals to find information about their family, because people are trying to find out who they are and where they came from.
And in the case of a family historian, you're getting to look at something that, for a lot of people, if it's an immigrant ancestor, it may have been a document that came with them on the voyage across the Atlantic. It may have taken 2 weeks, and it survived, and here we are in the early 21st century. You know, as a descendant, I have the opportunity to come and look at these documents and say, you know, this is part of my heritage too, and it's been preserved here at the National Archives. It's an incredible experience when you're handling the original documents, because, you know, the last time someone may have looked at this record may have been 100 years ago or more, when the person who was looking at the case for the person to get the pension was basically trying to make a decision whether or not this person was eligible for that pension. It's an incredible experience. And, you know, many genealogists will go to great lengths to have. You know, once we discover an ancestor, then we want to find information about them and hopefully document that they created.